The CHADS-VASC score can be used to determine the stroke risk in patients with atrial fibrillation. But what is the CHADS-VASC score and how is it used in atrial fibrillation? Atrial fibrillation increases the risk of stroke because atrial fibrillation leads to abnormal electrical activity in the atria, and this leads to the heart beating with an irregular rhythm. This abnormal electrical activity also leads to the atria not contracting properly. And if the atria do not contract properly, this leads to stasis of blood inside the atria. If there is blood stasis, this increases the risk of thrombi being formed in the atria. And these thrombi can embolize to different areas of the body, including the brain, and increase the risk of an ischemic stroke. So this is how atrial fibrillation can lead to stroke. The CHADS-VASC score is used in atrial fibrillation to evaluate this stroke risk. Each of the letters stands for a particular risk factor. C stands for patients who have a history of congestive heart failure. H refers to patients who have a history of hypertension. The first A refers to patients who are equal to or older than 75 years of age. D refers to patients who have a history of diabetes mellitus. The next S refers to patients who have had a previous stroke or a previous transient ischemic attack or a previous thromboembolism. The next V refers to patients who have a history of vascular diseases, such as having a prior myocardial infarction or peripheral arterial disease or having an aortic plaque. The next A refers to patients who are between the ages of 65 and 75 years of age. And the last S refers to sex, so specifically referring to patients who are female. So these are the risk factors that the CHADS-VASC score uses. A scoring system can be used to evaluate the stroke risk. Patients who have a history of congestive heart failure are scored 1 point. Patients who have a history of hypertension are scored 1 point as well. Patients who are equal to or older than 75 years of age are scored 2 points. This is why there's a 2 written in subscript next to the A. Patients who have a history of diabetes mellitus are scored 1 point. Patients who have had a previous stroke or a previous transient ischemic attack or a previous thromboembolism are scored 2 points. This is why there's a 2 written in subscript next to the S. Patients who have a history of vascular disease are scored 1 point. Patients who are between the ages of 65 and 74 years of age are scored 1 point. And finally, patients who are female are also scored 1 point. So this is how the CHADS-VASC score is calculated. The current NICE guidelines recommends that patients who have a CHADS-VASC score of 2 or more should receive anticoagulation therapy, as these patients are at a high risk of developing stroke. Anticoagulation therapy should also be considered in men who have a CHADS-VASC score of 1. But in women who have a CHADS-VASC score of 1, and that 1 point is only due to their gender and they have no other risk factors, NICE no longer recommends anticoagulation in these patients. For patients who are on anticoagulation therapy, another score is calculated. This score is called the HASBLED score, and the HASBLED score is used to evaluate the bleeding risk for patients who are on anticoagulation therapy. Again, each of the letters stands for a particular risk factor. The H refers to patients who have uncontrolled hypertension. The A refers to abnormal renal and liver function. Patients who have abnormal renal function include patients who are on dialysis, or patients who have had a kidney transplant, or patients who have raised serum creatinine levels. Patients who have abnormal liver function includes patients who have cirrhosis. The S refers to patients who have a history of stroke. B stands for bleeding and refers to patients who have a history of major bleeding, or patients who have a predisposition to bleeding, such as patients who have a bleeding disorder. L stands for labile INR and refers to patients who have an unstable INR or a high INR, or patients who spend a poor amount of time in the therapeutic range for the INR. E stands for elderly and refers to patients who are above or equal to the age of 65 years of age. D stands for drugs and alcohol use. Drugs includes medications that increases the risk of bleeding, such as antiplatelet medication and NSAIDs. Each of these factors will get 1 point on the HASBLED score. Please note that when calculating the HASBLED score, if a patient has both abnormal renal and liver function, that will score 2 points on the HASBLED score. And if a patient is both on drugs that will increase the risk of bleeding and also has a significant history of alcohol use, that will also score 2 points on the HASBLED score. So overall, the HASBLED score is calculated out of 9 points. If a patient has a HASBLED score of 3 or more, that is considered high risk of bleeding. And so for these patients, it's important to consider whether they need anticoagulation and to balance the benefits and risks of these patients getting anticoagulation.